Hi phage hunters, we are collecting some water samples today to see if what's lurking in this water behind us might be one of the solutions to antibiotic resistant bacteria. What we're looking for are phages. These are tiny viruses that attack and kill specific types of bacteria.
So what we're going to do today is show you how to use your phage hunter's kit.
First, you need to decide which water source you're going to get your water sample from. Now, phages exist everywhere on Earth, and there are actually more phages on Earth than there are stars in the universe. So there are plenty of opportunities to find phages in many different water sources anywhere on Earth.
So it's really important to ideally try and take someone with you for safety, and make sure that you can access the water's edge safely as well. So inside we've got a flyer, and this tells you everything you need to know about the whole process. And then we've got three jars for collection. So I'm going to get my first jar out and we're going to collect a sample. Okay, so we're going to open up our jar and we're going to fill it to the top. Ooh. Okay, filled to the top. And it's really important to really tightly squeeze on that lid. We don't want any leaks. So yes, and the next really important thing to do once you've done that is to wash your hands if you can, because as you'll hopefully find out, there are millions of microbes in water sources all around us, and some of them aren't too friendly. So the research team need to know exactly where you collected your sample from. So the best way to do that is to open up an app called What3Words, and I'm going to navigate to where I am, and that can pinpoint your location to within a 3 meter square. So the words that we need for here are rocket quite dozen. I'm going to write down the date that we took the sample on, and then you're ready to register your sample online. So you need to go onto the Citizen Phage Library and you need to put in all the details of where you collected your sample, who you are, and a really nice thing to do as well is to upload an image of where you've taken your sample from, so you can take a little photo of your location. Another nice thing to do is to take a selfie so that we get to know who the citizen scientists are. And if you're happy to, you can give permission for that to be used on the web pages and on social media, because it'd be so nice to know who's contributing to this fantastic project. So we'll do a quick selfie. There we go.
Okay, so keep your samples in the fridge until you send them, and the next thing to do is to register your samples online. So log on to citizenphage.com, fill in your details, upload your chosen photo, whether that's a selfie or the picture of where you took the samples, and get a returns label. You can then send the samples off to the Citizen Phage Library. So please send in your samples, contribute to this live research project, and who knows, you might discover the next weapon in the fight against superbugs.